Hello, I'm Congressman Robert Pittenger. The media won't tell you this, but the House Republicans have been hard at work fulfilling the promises that they made to the American people. We've been working together with President Trump to fulfill these commitments and make America great again. Mainstream media pundits would rather focus on their own agendas and their tabloid reporting, creating a new crisis every day. Did you know that the U.S. House of Representatives has passed more than 270 bills this year? More than under President Obama, and nearly twice as much as President Clinton. President Trump has already signed over 50 of those bills into law. This week, the House passed legislation to fund our national security priorities. We provided $1.6 billion for physical barrier construction along our southern border, fully meeting President Trump's budget request. We increased funding for our military by 13%, over $650 billion. To reverse the harmful cuts under President Obama, which he brought our readiness to the lowest level since World War II. We provided the largest pay raise for our troops in 8 years. We provided the highest level of funding ever for the Department of Veterans Affairs. President Trump has prioritized border security, a strong military to defeat ISIS, and respect for our veterans. Working with my House colleagues, we passed legislation to support our National Security Appropriations Bill that funds those priorities. Another key priority was to repeal and replace Obamacare, and we did it. We fulfilled that promise. As your congressman, earlier this year, I helped pass conservative legislation in the House of Representatives to repeal and replace Obamacare. The Senate must be responsible and complete this important promise. The House plan repeals Obamacare, removes the federal mandates and taxes, and replaces it with a market-driven healthcare system that will lower the cost, provide increased access to healthcare, and it'll protect pre-existing conditions. More importantly, it protects the life of the unborn. It defunds Planned Parenthood and preserves the Hyde Amendment. As a leader of the Congressional Pro-Life Caucus and Congressional Prayer Caucus, I've met with Vice President Pence and Speaker Ryan to ensure that these vital pro-life protections remain in the final legislation. Most significant reform of Medicaid in over 50 years was in our Obamacare bill. It'll save over $800 billion. Next, we protected our borders. We also funded $1.5 billion for additional border security measures to keep our nation safe. And we passed the No Sanctuary for Criminals Act. This ends dangerous sanctuary city policies, which protect unlawful and criminal immigrants from federal immigration enforcement. We passed Kate's Law, increases the penalties for deported felons who return to the United States. We created accountability at the Veterans Administration. We streamlined the process for firing or suspending VA employees for poor performance or misconduct. We advocate in our office and back in the district on an ongoing basis 500 veterans at any given time, helping them to expedite their VA claims. Next, we addressed regulatory reform. We passed the RAINS Act, which gives congressional oversight for major regulations, ends unchecked power of the bureaucrats. We passed, and President Trump signed, 13 reform laws ending unnecessary small business regulations, which also, in that same bill, we protected the Second Amendment. We protected the unborn. And we prevented federal takeover of local land and removing additional costly regulatory burdens on the economy. We also prevented the implementation of the Waters of the United States rule to protect America's farmers, ranchers, and cattlemen. Next, we passed financial regulatory reform. In the Choice Act, we repealed the burdensome Dodd-Frank regulations on small community banks. And we ended the taxpayer-funded bailouts and increased penalties for Wall Street bad actors. We reformed the CFPB by creating congressional budgeting and oversight and ending their unchecked authority. Let's look at what I work for our region. We secured over $1 billion of relief funding as a result of the Hurricane Matthew damage. More recently, I helped secure an additional $32 million in HUD Community Development Block grants that funded as well as a result of Hurricane Matthew. Previously, Governor Cooper erroneously stated that North Carolina would only receive $6.1 million. This $32 million is a result of my reaching out to Secretary Carson to ensure that the most up-to-date information was used in calculating North Carolina's final allocation. Also, I helped secure $1 million in funding to repair public buildings in Robeson that were damaged by Hurricane Matthew. As well, I gave major focus to securing funding for a new airport control tower at the Charlotte Douglas International Airport to replace an airport tower that was outdated, it underperformed, it was unsafe for the world's sixth busiest airport. As well, I created increased access and flexibility for USDA grants for our rural communities. We advanced efforts to secure now a new Doppler radar for the region to detect tornadoes and severe weather. Currently, Charlotte is the only major city without Doppler radar in the United States. Despite what you might hear or not hear in the mainstream media, the U.S. House of Representatives has had a busy and productive first 6 months of 2017. I'm honored to be your representative in Washington, and I'm here to serve you. Please call me in my offices at any time to assist you. Thank you, and God bless you.